I was in Idaho last year, and it was a Mexican doctor that came to see me, a lady. And she said, I have a practice down in Mexico, and my partner was approached by a Catholic and said, the bishop is dying of cancer, but he knows you Adventists have a special health message. Would you be willing to treat him? The doctor said, if on a condition that I can give the bishop Bible studies. I want to explain to him where that health message came from. And he went back and came back and said, the bishop says yes. Okay, sent the bishop to my office. So the bishop started coming. He put him on a special plan, prayed with him, and pretty soon the cancer started to disappear. And eventually it totally disappeared. And but now it's time for the doctor to knock on the house of the bishop. Hello, Brother Bishop, I am here to give you a Bible study. Can I come in? The bishop said, please do. You're welcome. They talked for a while, and he said, okay, I'd like to discuss with you the spirit of prophecy and how it gave us the health message. Could I do that? The bishop said, yes, but before you do, could I show you something? Come with me to my library. So they went to the library. And on the library, all of the published writings of Ellen G. White. The doctor was stunned. Brother Bishop, how in the world do you have all these books? He said, and I've read every one of them too. You have. And what do you think about them? He said, I'm a Jesuit. It is my job to read everything. And I want you to know that we Jesuits believe that Ellen G. White is the only true prophet of any church today. And we believe everything she has written. And I will tell you another thing. That is why we don't want Seventh-day Adventists to believe anything that she writes. Because if they do, they will know everything we're doing and everything we're planning to do. This was a stunning news to our doctor. You know everything that we do, and we don't even believe and act on what we've received.